I just don't understand how in Canada you can be proposing to hand over more food safety functions to the meatpacking companies. I mean, you just need to look at what's happened in the United States when the United States has done that. If no one had ever tried that idea before, it might make sense. But, you know, we just had the biggest E. coli recall in history this year in the United States. So the American system is broken, and I'm not quite sure why you want to imitate it.
Well, because I think there's no connection with people and their food. I don't think people realize what's in their food, where it's coming from.
Yeah.
How do you think things got so bad?
Well, things got so bad because, you know, people have been alienated from food system, from any kind of awareness of food production. And it's not accidental. I mean, these companies work very hard not to show you, not to tell you where this food comes from. Their marketing tends to involve pictures of, you know, farm animals out in beautiful rolling countryside. And there is this illusion that is manipulated of where our food is coming from. The reality is very, very different. The book that I've written about, yeah, I mean,
we're falling
apart. Yeah, it's okay. But I mean, you know, my book, Fast Food Nation, was really about trying to show people where their food's coming from. And this film by Robbie Kenner, you know, is made in exactly the same spirit. It's about lifting the veil and showing you the reality of food production today. But bringing it back to Canada, I mean, this memo that was leaked from the Tories, it was clear that not only did they want to, you know, hand over more food safety to the meatpacking companies and reduce inspections and reduce testing for BSC, but there was a real concern in the memo about communicating this policy to the public, and for good reason. In the current system, I think, really is dependent on our ignorance. And these companies want to keep us ignorant, and the government wants to as well. And I know that sounds very paranoid and conspiratorial, but you're certainly not seeing photographs of these feedlots, you know, on your hamburger package. And, you know, when you go buy bacon at the store, it doesn't show you how the hogs are being raised at all. Because, you know, if you really saw how these animals are being treated, you may not want to eat them.
There's also no transparency with the companies in terms of, they won't even give you an interview. I mean, tell me about trying to get access
to
them.
Well, you know, again, I mean, we're in Canada, so I'm just going to keep on talking about Canada. I mean, one of the things that your government has done recently is stop publicizing the lists of processing plants where, you know, they were doing a poor job with their hygiene, or any kind of ranking of companies in terms of hygiene. Now, if you believe in the free market, that's exactly the kind of information people should have, because then you can make your purchasing decision based on what companies are doing a good job, what companies are doing a bad job. And what's so ironic about both the Harper government and the Republican administrations in the United States is they talk about free market, they talk about the workings of free enterprise, but the kind of decisions that they make deny consumers information to, you know, to make the market work effectively. Labeling is a huge issue, and it's one of the issues that the film looks at. For the market to work properly, you need access to information. That's what labels are all about. But these food processors do everything they can to keep things off of the label, for example, genetically modified ingredients. In the United States and Canada, there's no labeling of GMOs. Most Americans don't know the genetically modified food is already on sale at their supermarket. One of the big debates recently in the United States was over cloning, where they want to introduce cloned meat without having to label it. Now, why do they want to do that? Because their own surveys show that Americans don't want to eat the meat of cloned animals. And just to get back to Canada, I mean, one of the proposals in that memo that was leaked here in Canada was to hand over more power over labeling to the food companies themselves. Now, that sort of proposal, it's almost impossible to argue that that's in the public interest. I mean, that's clearly, you know, in the interest of some private companies, but how could it possibly be in the public interest to give more power over labeling to the companies who have everything to gain by controlling what's on the label.
I guess that's
I'm just kind of ranting again.
No,
but I mean,
it's enough.
But, you know, this is, you know, it's, the film is extremely critical of what's happened in the United States as regards to food production. But no one should be so complacent as to believe this is just a problem in the United States. It's a problem in Canada, and it's a problem everywhere where this sort of centralized, industrialized agriculture has spread.
And what are you hoping the film will be able to do?
I really hope the film will open people's eyes and make them think and make them question. And then the next step, you know, is to do something about it. But it's not agitprop. It's not a Michael Moore film telling you what to think. But in its simplest form, it's showing you a world that's deliberately hidden from you. And it's important. I mean, it's not an expose of the fashion industry and how they come up with their designs. You know, the food industry is the most important industry. This product enters your body. It helps determine whether you'll be healthy or unhealthy. It helps determine your longevity and the health of your children. So this is something that you should know about.
But I know I have to wrap, but yeah. There is change. I mean, I see change everywhere.
Yeah.
Awareness, organic markets popping up all over the city.
Yeah.
It's huge. So do you have hope? What kind of hope do you have for the future?
I mean, and people are often surprised to hear this because it just seems like I must be such a bummer talking about all these really terrible abuses. But I'm hugely optimistic, and I first started the research on this subject for Fast Food Nation in 1997. So I'm, you know, more than 10 years into really investigating the food system and looking at it, and already I've seen changes, real changes in people's attitude, in production, the huge expansion in organic and sustainable agriculture, in local agriculture, movements towards animal welfare. So change is happening, and there is a genuine social movement around food that's taken root, and that's all good, but it's begun and it has to continue, and people need to be aware, and then they need to do something.